Welcome to Smart Went Crazy Podcast. We are back. It's been about a week or two. Here we're season two. Joe and I are back on the scene. Got a couple things we want to discuss. The chat is at a decent level. We'll let some people get here. It's something different for the intro, you know, something. How are you doing, Joe?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Good. So we're gonna start it off a little light, talk about some Bills NFL playoffs. Bills lost, but you know, we made it this year. After the 18-year drought, we're finally back in. I was a little upset of how we played, but you know, what are you gonna do? At least we got the monkey off our back. Right away today, actually, we fired Rick Dennison, which thank God. This guy was just not right for our team. He always wanted to run up the middle with Tolbert, get 1 yard. 3rd and 25. Let's run up the middle with Mike Tolbert. We'll see what happens.
Why is my face so huge on this
podcast? Oh, yeah. Here, let me fix that. We can go back and forth. Whoever's talking will get the screen. So I'm talking right now. I'll get the screen. I'll just handle all that. I wasn't really paying attention, though. But, Joe, what do you think about that?
You want to know my true opinion or what?
Yeah. Of course, I always want your true opinion. Is there ever not a true opinion for Joe? Joe, you tell it how it is. That's why I like you on the show.
Give me a moment, and I will explain everything.
All right.
So if you take your X and your O, and you equal those together, minus the 1 plus 6 equals 4.
Let me check the chat real quick. We got Scott Semlak, my brother. Haven't heard this song in a long time. Awesome. Yeah, I like that song too.
It's supposed to look like, I don't know if you can see that, but it says, Bills suck.
You're a hater.
Bills suck. Let me put it to you like this, boys and girls. Black and yellow, black and yellow, black and yellow. Look at that. Stitch Antonio Brown, Le'Veon Bell hat right there. Every nice. Day. Hey, I'm sorry. I'm happy that the Bills got in the playoff, but that's the way it is. You know what I'm saying?
All right, we're gonna get more into the playoffs, but I want to start it off with something funny, something happy, something everybody can laugh at. So I got a video off of Deadspin.com that I want to show. It's Bills fans getting rowdy and crazy, lighting each other on fire, throwing each other through tables. Who is not – anyone who's been to a Bills game will know right away that this is nothing out of the ordinary. This is an everyday Bills fan thing. But Deadspin.com seems to love Buffalo. They think we're like the craziest town out there, which is great. I'll take that title all day of the week. So – Doesn't that just bring a tear to your eye?
Not at all.
You know, I thought when I felt one coming, but you know, I'm gonna hold off for now. I'm gonna hold my emotions in for that one. But yeah, it was a good year. It was a fun year. That's why I'm wearing the Bills hat right now. You know, I think we made the right move. Where was the problem this year? It was in the offense. All right, fired the offensive coordinator. You know, it was our first year in the playoffs. We're not going to clean the whole house out. You know, you can't get rid of McDermott. He got us in the playoffs first time in 18 years. You can't fire him. The defense 17. Was 17. Well, almost 18. It was coming up on 18.
17.
But technically 17. Right. So, all right. You're right. 17.
I know.
But I don't know. Yeah, I think that was the right move. I am also a Steelers fan, Joe. So, I'm not gonna hate on you for liking the Steelers. Because the Steelers have been my fallback team for years.
You want to know how much of a Steelers fan I am, bro?
Let us know.
Black and yellow, black and yellow.
I love you, Joe. Black and yellow. But right, yo, I gotta give a disclosure real quick before you go on with this. So before we started this live feed, I showed Joe the new intro. He's like, "What the hell is that?" I go, "What do you mean? That's a cool song. It says Smart Run Crazy. It's a cool intro." Joe's like, "I wanted black and yellow. I liked black and yellow better." I just thought that was funny.
Let me show you. See the bag? Yep. I'm about to show it to you, son. What is that, a football? Is that a football?
Who's that signed by?
Is that Antonio Brown's signature?
Damn, son. Where'd you get that?
Is that official NFL sold material right there?
Where'd you find that?
That the Duke right there, game ball right there. Is that Antonio Brown's signature? No one has. I have it.
I like how you cut the tag on. Nice.
It's my favorite ball in the whole wide world.
Are you going to get it signed by anybody else or are you just going to keep it like that?
No. It's only going to have his signature on it.
So what if Le'Veon Bell...
Black and yellow. If I could get Antonio Brown, Le'Veon Bell, and Ben Roethlisberger all on this ball, I would be amazed.
Look, what about this? All right, I know the Killer Bees are usually known as Ben Roethlisberger, Antonio Brown, and Le'Veon Bell, but a true Steelers fan, included and you included too, true Steelers fan will also throw in Boswell, the kicker, he's a B, Bryant, the other wide receiver.
Bryant is going to be gone this year.
Right. But, I mean, I'm saying in the past 2 years, a true Steelers fan would consider all those players as one of the killer bees.
And would call, still consider it the killer bees because it's going to be Ben Roethlisberger to Le'Veon Bell to Antonio Brown. And then to make the killer bees, it's going to be Juju Smith-Schuster.
Wait a minute. Okay, so where's the B in Juju Smith-Schuster?
It's not a B, it's an S. Killer Bees.
Oh, I got you. Kinda, but whatever. I'll just pretend
B-E-E-S. B-E-E-S, Bees.
Okay, what about the E in the E, though?
What?
So you're making it an acronym now. B-E-E-S. So where are the two E's? I'm saying bees as in just B with a plural. You're saying
why do you got to argue with me? It's B-E-E. Because
it's the best content in the world, me and you argue. I get it all. I get messages all the time that when me and you argue, that's the best shows.
Deal with it.
All right. So moving on. What do you got going for the Super Bowl? What are your picks?
My picks. Let's see. You want to bet some money?
Yeah, let's do it. $20.
$20. Deal.
I got $20, and I'm taking Philly versus Pittsburgh in the battle for Pennsylvania. But the only problem is we have a conflict of interest here. We both think the Steelers are going to win.
Let me break it down for you.
Go ahead.
For the AFC Championship. It's going to be, if the following teams win, it's going to be If the Pats win, it'll be if the Pats and Steelers go to the AFC Championship, that's a toss-up. They're evenly matched. So, if the Steelers go in the AFC, because there's no way Tennessee's going to get in. So, we'll talk. We got to go over to the
NFC. Yeah, you got that right.
Okay. So, the Eagles are out. The Vikings are in. The Saints are in. So it's going to be the Saints and the Vikings.
Wait, hold on a second. Why are the Eagles out so fast?
Eagles are out. They're going to lose this weekend.
What do you think? Why do you think that so easily, though?
They don't have Carson Wentz.
What about Nick Foles?
They don't have Carson Wentz. They're not the same team as they were with Carson Wentz. I'm sorry.
Yeah. You're probably right.
But they're not.
Isn't Wentz coming back though? If they make it past this round.
He tore his ACL, bro.
Oh, he's out for the year?
He's out for the year.
Oh, I didn't know. Someone was telling me he might come back.
No, they were wrong. Oh. So it's going to be the Saints or the Vikings. If the Vikings play the Saints, the Vikings will win because their defense is unreal. Okay? So you have your championship as the Vikings versus the Pats or Steelers. If the Vikings play the Pats, the Vikings win. If the Vikings play the Steelers win.
All I got to say is this. Now, Nick Foles is not just someone to sniff at. I mean, he was a Pro Bowl. I think he was the MVP of the Pro Bowl, but I know he was in the Pro Bowl. Whatever. Forget about the Pro Bowl. That's nothing. I just think he's good enough. With that team, how stacked Philly is, I think that's the type of team that would win with Trent Dilfer. That's the Trent Dilfer team right now. So that's... They're just stacked everywhere. They have five amazing wide receivers, three good running backs. Their defense is loaded. They just need a quarterback that can manage the game. I think Nick Foles can do that. So I'm not counting Philly out that easily. But second of all, I want to agree with you on this. AFC, regardless if it's Pittsburgh or New England, and it's definitely not going to be Tennessee, between those two teams, one of those teams is winning the Super Bowl this year. I just can't see it happening any other way. Those are the two teams. Like, it's going to be the AFC again this year.
It's always going to be the AFC. AFC is the better league.
Right now. I mean, there's been years where the NFC was just way better. But right now, yeah. Right now, the AFC is definitely a lot stronger, I think. But then, what about the Saints? You know what I mean? The Saints, I mean, you got the Saints over there. The beginning of the playoff picture, looking at both sides, it was actually pretty evenly matched. But now you're right. Right now it's AFC all day.
I know what I'm talking about, man.
Yeah, you do.
Me and Tony Romo are best friends. He calls me and asks me for advice.
Tony Romo?
Mm-hmm.
Tony Romo's on point. Dude, he's a natural when it comes to commentating, I think. I think he found his niche, if you know what I mean.
Yeah. Better at commentating than he was at football, but that's besides the point.
I don't know. He wasn't too bad.
He wasn't too bad. He never brought his team to the Super Bowl, though.
That, my friend, is a fact.
Facts hurt. Truth hurts.
Yep.
So what's up with this chat? Not a single person is in here. Frank Wolf says, when do the Haitians play El Salvador?
We got three people right now.
I don't see any number of people.
I got three on my end.
Maybe somebody can start talking a little bit in the chat. What do we think?
The El Salvadorians? All right, well, listen. I want to show something because this week's been crazy with politics, right? Everyone's going nuts about Oprah Winfrey. We're gonna get into the whole Trump and the shithole towns thing. I want to talk about that and give my two cents on that. But first, I want to play a clip from 1989 of Oprah Winfrey and Donald Trump when Oprah had Donald Trump as a guest on her show. So here you go.
major U.S. newspapers last year criticizing U.S. foreign policy. What would you do differently, Donald?
I'd make our allies, forgetting about the enemies. The enemies you can't talk to so easily. I'd make our allies pay their fair share. We're a debtor nation. Something's going to happen over the next number of years with this country, because you can't keep going on losing $200 billion, and yet we let Japan come in and dump everything right into our markets and everything. It's not free trade. If you ever go to Japan right now and try to sell something, forget about it, Oprah. Just forget about it. It's almost impossible. They don't have laws against it. They just make it impossible. They come over here, they sell their cars, their VCRs, they knock the hell out of our companies. And, hey, I have tremendous respect for the Japanese people. I mean, you can respect somebody that's beating the hell out of you, but they are beating the hell out of this country. Kuwait, they live like kings. The poorest person in Kuwait, they live like kings. And yet they're not paying. We make it possible for them to sell their oil. Why aren't they paying us 25% of what they're making? It's a joke.
This sounds like political presidential talk to me. And I know people have talked to you about whether or not you want to run. Would you ever?
Probably not. But I do get tired of seeing the country ripped off.
Why would you not?
I just don't think I really have the inclination to do it. I love what I'm doing. I really like it.
Also, it doesn't pay as well.
No, it doesn't. But, you know, I just probably wouldn't do it, Oprah. I probably wouldn't, but I do get tired of seeing what's happening with this country. And if it got so bad, I would never want to rule it out totally, because I really am tired of seeing what's happening with this country, how we're really making other people live like kings, and we're not.
What do you think of this year's presidential race, the way it's shaping up?
Well, it's going to be very interesting. I think that probably George Bush has an advantage in terms of the election. I think that probably people would say that he's got like that little edge in terms of the incumbency, et cetera, et cetera. But I think just.
All right. So there's a reason why I wanted to show people that. I know it's a long time ago and it doesn't mean anything today. Good point. Valid. Got that. But if you just listen to what Trump was saying right there, everything he was just talking about, he's doing right now. Think about it. Did you listen to that, Joe?
Yes.
That's what he's doing. He's literally pulling out of these crazy UN deals that we're paying. If you look it up, you could actually go online right now. You could go to United States government official website.
I want to cut you off for a second.
Yeah, go ahead.
Frank Wolf, you're always saying you love us. I've seen you on this show 8,000 times. I need you to bring more fans to this show. Frank, you need to tell every one of your friends to come watch us, because we are amazing. We are better than Bowerly and Bella Via, baby.
Oh yeah, Frank, by the way, I didn't forget about you telling me to send you some pictures of the Lincolns we got. I'll send you some pictures tomorrow. I just was getting some pictures together for you, so you'll get that. But yeah, Joe, back to this Trump thing.
Mm-hmm.
There's a reason why. There's a method to my madness right now. I want to tie this all together. So now we got Oprah coming on the award ceremony, talking about, you know, women's equality payment or gender gap or whatever. She's getting everybody all riled up, you know, all this feminist stuff, whatever. That's fine. Then you got back in '89, Trump saying that if it ever got so bad, he would actually run, and that he would make sure that all these other countries would pay their fair share, and that we wouldn't get the shit end of the stick anymore. You see that happening now. You see the biggest tax cuts in history going down, all right? So all of a sudden today and yesterday, this bombshell gets dropped, right? Everybody says, and it's, first of all, it's not even confirmed. It's just he said, she said stuff about Trump saying, why are all these people from these shithole countries coming here? So I got the CNN report right here. Here it is, and I'm gonna. I just want to get everybody on the same page as me real quick before I get my point, because I think even if Trump said all this stuff, I agree. That's something a president shouldn't be saying about other countries, and I'm not gonna say that it's okay that he said anything like that. But just so here's the report, right? It says here's Donald Trump's tweet. The language used by me at the DACA meeting was tough, but this was not the language used. What was really tough was the outlandish proposal made, a big setback for DACA. Now, all this is coming in the wake of Trump saying that he, instead of getting rid of DACA, he was going to rethink it and, you know, give these children who are here another chance to stay here and become citizens. Then he says right here, never said anything derogatory about Haitians other than Haiti is obviously a very poor and troubled country. Never said take them out, made up by Dems. I have a wonderful relationship with Haitians. Probably should record future meetings. Unfortunately, no trust. Now, I'm giving you all this information for a reason, right? Because CNN, Jimmy Kimmel, everyone, Colbert, you name it. They're all coming out and just going, they're flailing their arms around. Oh my God, he's so evil. Oh my God, he said the horrible things. And I find it funny how all of a sudden now, if you say anything bad about these countries, now it's labeled as bigotry, right? But when Trump or the Republicans in general were talking about putting bans on countries, poor countries who are coming to the United States, they would say, oh, they need to come here. Those countries are so shitty. Oh, that we need to help them, right? Those countries are poor and tore up. No one can live there. So now all of a sudden, when Trump says the same thing that they were saying, it's bigotry. Oh my God. And then, so Trump said, and I want to sound like I'm defending Trump. The only thing I'm trying to get across here is the media, how they spin shit. And I don't know what it is about me. I just see it for what it is. I just call it out right away. Bullshit. So they're saying, all right, Trump was talking about, we need more people from Norway. People who are just, and they made it seem right away this was a racial thing because there's a lot of white people in Norway, which I don't think is the case at all. That's just silly. It's just silly to comprehend it that way. And it's funny because Bernie Sanders for so long was like, we need to be more like Norway and Sweden, and we need a universal health and universal education. But what about, you name those countries, but what about, why don't you want to be more like Haiti? Something not right there? Or did you just prove our point that some countries are shitholes? We're not talking about the people that live there. We're talking about the governments there. So one of the things that first popped in my head today was when you look at countries like Iran, the countries who are, they make their people practice a certain religion, right? They make their people, Saudi Arabia comes to mind. They make their people dress a certain way. Women can't do certain things, right? This is where I'm tying it all together. So you got Oprah and the award ceremony saying that women need equal pay to men. This is our country is, in other words, our country is, inequality for women and men, right? But then you got these countries where women can't even drive, or get a job, or men can't even wear hair gel. So what blows my mind about all this is when you the double standards, you see what I'm saying? So you label, if you talk about a country in a bad light for not, living up to our standards, it's bigotry. But then when our standards are so high that you think that other people deserve to live here and come here, do you see what I'm saying about a double standard, Joe?
Absolutely.
Here, I got one more thing I want to say real quick.
Sure.
Louis Black, comedian Louis Black, once said, quote, he said, gay marriage is number 6 on the list of things Americans worry about, next to number 5, which is, are we eating too much? In other words, America, people in America have it so good here, right? That what we look at as problems, other countries look at as benefits, okay? Now, the point I'm trying to make is when I hear these rants or these speeches about inequality and how bad America was never great. What are you talking about? Make America great again? America was never great. My question is, in comparison to what? What are you comparing us to? You know what I mean? I'm a glass half full type of guy. I believe in being progressive and making things better. I'm all for it. All right? I'm all for it, I'm all for gender equality. I'm all for it. But just what I can't stand is when people make it look like that there's like this evil patriarchy in force that's trying to put everything down except for themselves. And you know, like I was saying, in comparison to what? Because that's, to me, it's just, I don't get the point of it. I just don't get the point of it.
So, first and foremost, here's what I'm going to say. You're talking about, Frank Wolf says our sound quality is great.
Thank you.
By the way, he's watching with his 3-year-old son, so no swearing.
Thanks, Blake.
We did come to the, I came to the reunion, Blake.
Yeah, I was kind of, we'll just say I was held up at the moment. But go ahead, Joe. I want to hear what you had to say about this.
So, with that being said, here's my opinion. First and foremost, Donald Trump shouldn't have said what he said. I'm sorry. I can't agree with anything that was said by Donald Trump.
Real quick, not to cut you off. I'm going to be 2 seconds. Nobody really knows exactly what he said. It's quotes from he said, she said. Now, if what CNN said was exactly true, you're right. I agree with you 100%. He shouldn't have said that. But go ahead.
He definitely said that, dude.
All right, whatever. Then you're right. He should have held that to himself. You're right.
It's Donald Trump. It's not like...
But exactly, what do you expect? People didn't vote for him for being a nice guy. People voted for him because they wanted a wrecking ball. And now here we have a wrecking ball. I don't know. I'm not flailing my arms around going, oh my God. This is exactly what we expected. This is exactly what we wanted, people who voted for him. I didn't even vote for Trump. But I'm speaking for them right now. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't even vote for him. I don't even know if I still would.
I don't know. I don't know, man. As far as I'm concerned, he made a big, big goof and he screwed himself.
To me, this is like every other thing he's tweeted about. When are people just going to be like, all right, this is him. This is who got elected. Like, at the end of the day, I mean, whatever. If you want to express your concern, I get it. Everyone has a right to their opinion. But, like, I just don't get the media act so surprised. Every time this shit happens, the media, like CNN, they go nuts. Like, oh, my God, is this impeachable? Is this an impeachable offense? No, it's not. It's actually not. Is it to the point where maybe people are not going to vote for him next time around? Maybe. Maybe he should keep his mouth shut. Maybe you're right.
If Donald Trump gets reelected next 4 years, I'll be extremely surprised.
Really? Even after the biggest tax cut in the history of the United States? Even after pulling us out of deals that the United States and the United Nations, the United States were paying 90%? There's some deals that we got out of. Like, look at some of these trade deals that we were just getting shitted on. He's pulling out. I mean, to me, it's like this. There's people who are going to not vote for him, who did vote for him, because of his mannerisms, because of the shit he says, the shit he tweets.
Don't swear.
But I think there's people who don't care about any of that, who are just looking at, did he cut taxes? Yes. Is he getting us out of these trade deals? Yes. Is he, you know what I'm saying? And that's, those people are going to, like Frank Wolf said in the chat, his core base does not care what he tweets. They don't.
I don't know what you want me to tell you.
I don't know. I just, and you know what? I guess I agree with you. I'm not sure if he's going to win another term. And I don't even know if I would vote for him. You know what I mean? But I guess we're waiting to see what happens. We'll wait and see how the economy gets. We'll wait and see about, you know, unemployment and This is the way I see it. At the end of the day, it's all going to come down to numbers. If there's economic growth, then people will respond positively. That's all people really care about at the end of the day. All this other stuff is just, it's just a shit show. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Now, to compare him to Obama, of course we have to do that. Of course you have to. Now, Obama, I think, was phenomenal. What he did was phenomenal with criminal justice. All right? I think what he did in the criminal justice department with, you know, people who have nonviolent, maybe some drug charges, should not be going to prison. All right? Now, you got Jeff Sessions trying to repeal that. Those are the things that, at the end of the day, blow my mind. Why are Republicans doing that shit? Aren't they supposed to be the Freedom Party? Don't they want people, you know what I mean? So, the whole marijuana legalization thing, Obama pushed for legalization. Now you got Jeff Sessions and Trump and all them pushing for, well, Trump never really said anything about it, but Jeff Sessions in particular, pushing to make it illegal. These are the things that I think are no-brainers. It's like, majority of the country wants the weed to be legal. Just make it legal. You'll make money. States will have more GDP at the end of the day. You know what I mean? You'll be able to make sales. You'll be able to tax it. I think that's a no-brainer.
I agree.
But, yeah, that's actually a topic we could talk about next show. Joe and I have decided that we're going to do a Thursday night show from here on out every week. So stay tuned. I got Frank Wolf in the chat saying, I voted Trump for this platform, which is being put in place, the wall built, he will win in 2020. Yeah, and I mean, we'll see. Yeah, I don't think that's crazy to say at all. But, you know, I didn't want to, you know, I just wanted to have a quick show today.
Blake says we will gain only if the rich gain. That is incorrect. The rich.
No, I get what he's saying, though, because he's basically, correct me if I'm wrong, Blake, but what he's saying is if business owners or rich people or people who create jobs have more money in their pockets, then at the end of the day, they'll be able to hire more people, give out more raises, and create more jobs. It's really that simple. And a lot of people look at trickle-down economics like it's a big failure. But trickle-down economics doesn't work if government keeps spending. If government can cut spending, trickle economics can work. Reaganomics worked. 80s was great. The 90s was great. The Bush era, of course, was not great. We were in war the whole time. We were spending millions and trillions of dollars on weapons. So, and he barely cut taxes, by the way. So you can't really say that it was trickle-down economics. It wasn't. It was just Bush. But I get what he's saying. I don't think what he's saying is wrong at all.
Well, you know, I definitely understand, but we just wanted to come on and do a quick show. We're going to be going on Thursday nights every night, or Thursday nights every week. I'm trying to get my computer up and running so I can see the chat better.
Yeah, Joe, I got a webcam for you and a microphone.
So we will be up and running pretty soon. But other than that, I mean, you know, good, quick little show. It wasn't as informative as last time, but, we look forward to next week and we will be talking about the Steelers and the Jags.
Yeah.
And everything that happens during the week.
Yeah. We're going to, we got a whole week to plan something out. I think I want to talk more about weed legalization and the opiate epidemic, Joe, if that's all right with you. But also, you know, if you got any ideas, leave a comment about something that's dear to you that's going on right now. Any trending topic, could be a movie that just came out, video game you like, and we'll you know what I mean, we'll me and Joe will get on it. So that's it for today. But yeah. Stay smart, everybody.
Stay crazy.
All right. Have a good one.
Bye.